Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This week's question sounded really, really easy, but it's not. We have a year and a month, and a whole bunch of records down here. It goes from row 7 down to row 210. I want to figure out how many of those records fall in that month. I thought there were going to be a lot of different ways to do this. Here's what I came up with. I'm going to create a little lookup table over here. It starts at the date of 0. It gives us a value of 0. Now here, I want to put in the date, the first of the month. So I'm going to use equal date value, equal date value. And tell you what, let's make the Excel window a little bit smaller here so that way we can fit that in the window. Scroll over a little bit. Equal date value. Now, date value converts text that looks like a date into a real date. And one of the things I've noticed is that they can deal with something like April space 1 comma space 2010. So I'm going to use cell B4 ampersand a comma space. Say a space 1 comma space. Ampersand that year over there, and that should convert those words and numbers into a real date. There we go, let's change that to a short date. Sure enough, 4/1/2011. Let's try, we'll go to another month, May. Beautiful, it's working. And then, so anything that is greater than or equal to that date gets a value of 1 up to the first of the next month. So equal EOMONTH, equal EOMONTH. Comma 0. That's going to get me to, in this case, May 31st, so I add 1, and it'll get me to June 1st, so anything beyond that gets a 0. Alright, so now it's simple. From here, have to do a VLOOKUP into all of those dates. Notice I said VLOOKUP, but unfortunately, VLOOKUP doesn't work in an array formula, so I'm going to go back to the old, never use it, but in this case, certainly use it. Lookup. So we want to look up all of those dates, comma, and this little table here. It always is a comma true version. We can just stop right there. So that's going to do all those lookups. Of course, we are going to get zeros and ones there, so I need to sum that whole thing. And then Control Shift Enter. Bam! May 2011, 14. Let's try April 2011, 5. It is working. All right, Mike, let's see what you have.
We have our little data set here. And the only way I know how to take criteria inputs like this and compare it to a column of serial numbers is to use the text function. Let's just see what happens if I use the text function. And it's expecting a value, any number. This is a serial number under there, number of days since December 31st, 1899. So I'm going to say, hey, take that value and format it. Now, format text requires that you know custom number format, and the custom number format has to be in double quotes. But date custom number format is easy. I'm just going to say year, year, year. That'll give me a year in 4 digits, and then MMM. That gives me the abbreviation, the word, 3-character abbreviation of the month. And right now I can see, if I highlight this and hit F9, perfect. From that, I now have something that can be compared to these two criteria. Control Z. Now, instead of just that single cell, I'm going to click in this top cell, Control Shift Down Arrow, F4 to jump the screen back up. Now, that'll give me an array of values, and this text function I'm going to put inside of the sum product, because sum product can handle an array. But this array right here, I'm going to say, hey, is anything in that array equal to this, and then the join symbol, ampersand, shift 7, and that. Right now, if I highlight this, I get a series of trues and falses. Control Z. Trues and falses cannot be counted by sum product, but no problem. I have slapped, in essence, this array right there, and that array argument can handle arrays. But I need those trues and falses to be ones and zeros, so I'm going to use double negative to convert the trues and zeros to ones and false. And I want this equal sign to calculate before that unitary operator, a negative sign, double negative. And so I have to put that in parentheses, close parentheses, and count. If I change this to 2011, I get 5. All right, throw it back over to Mr. Excel.
Hey, all right, Mike, that was cool. I love that solving the problem that I was dealing with, just formatting the whole thing as text. Simple sum product, much easier than my way to go. I want to thank everyone for stopping by. See you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.